Yep. Good stuff. Ah, got my beverages here. Crispy, clear water, straight from the mountains of Pennsylvania. What mountains would those be, Dave? Poconos.
Mountains and Poconos.
Hills?
Hills, really. Yeah, they're not really that great. Dude, I wouldn't really drink any of the liquid that came off of the Pocono Mountains anyway. It's fake snow, which is like ice shit, and got dirty. It's dirty. Here, let me have some of this.
Yep, springtime again. Recorded last year in springtime. Recorded this year in springtime. And I think the weather is about the same. It's funny, you know, sometimes certain days, a whole year later, it can be like really cold, just like for some crazy reason, or it could be like way hotter, you know. Man, back in April, we had a couple of hot days. Weather pisses me off. I like weather, though. Weather's cool. I've been in my share of crazy weather incidents, you know, from, thunderstorms to... I wouldn't say flooding. I wouldn't say, like, natural disaster, like, this is really bad stuff kind of flooding. But, just kind of a couple inches, you know, roads get shut down, you know, little things like that. Nothing hardcore. And then, you know, I've been in a hurricane, you know? I've been in fucking hurricanes, man. Vacationing in Mexico. When was that? I can't remember the hurricane name. It was Hurricane I'm a Son of a Bitch. Yeah. Vacationing in Mexico, you know, hurricane winds were very strong. I saw, I think it was like big lizards being blown around on the road outside of where we were staying. I just remember seeing, I had this image, it's kind of like almost really burned in my brain. There's just this image of this kind of like dead large lizard, not an iguana or anything. But he was just being blown along the road. And, oh man. And yeah, that was pretty crazy. Crazy. That was a long time ago. I was a kid. Fun stuff, man. Mexico's a great place. So let's see here. Nothing like nighttime driving, though. I like nighttime driving. Especially in the country. I mean, you gotta be really kind of careful of certain things, especially animals. Here in Pennsylvania, it's not like, this isn't any, real country area. It's, you know... We got Philadelphia, but I'm not in Philadelphia. I'm about an hour away. I'm in the suburbs. We got our forests. Actually, just the other night, last night, I think, I was driving down the street that connects to my street. And there's, you know, fucking deer on the road still, you know? We still got our deer. We got our deer in Pennsylvania. We like our deer, especially up north and in the Pocono areas. Of course, not a lot of deer. Not as many deer as there used to be. Especially around my specific area, my neighborhood, I guess you could say. These fucking fuckheads just keep on ripping down the trees and building up new more homes, and they're bigger homes. Okay. Let me go into this. Let's see. Across the street from me, we got another row of houses, you know, up and down. I'm actually on a block, so behind me there would be another house. People on the other side of the street kind of had it a little easier. They don't have people behind them. They just had, like, kind of woods or, you know, it's been a long time since I've been on the other side of the street at one of their homes. You know, I don't really, you know. But anyway, they just had their wilderness back there. You know, it wasn't a fucking jungle or anything. But now these assholes fucking cleared out the woods there. So I assume what their view is now, instead of the trees and the canopy, you know, in the summertime, they got fucking houses way back there, and it's these big old fucks, it's these big old lummox fuckhead houses, you know, they really build these things big now. I was curious, I went onto their road, I drove up there just to check out, you know, what's this place look like, you know, this is a new place right in my neck of the woods, I wanna look at it, and it's just really awkward, it's hard to describe, it's not like a straight line of houses in a row, it's kind of like a weird cul-de-sac that isn't a cul-de-sac, though. And then there's a lot of land. I don't know. It's like they're half finished. No, they never completed, and it doesn't seem like they are gonna complete. Like there's all this open land, and then there's like six houses, and I'm like, what the fuck are they doing? There's like only six houses. All that for six?
And then there's like other land over there, and the and the yards look really shitty. I don't know, but that's the case with new houses and homes. You know, you gotta grow your shit. You know, you can't unless you luck out and you have like kind of tall trees on your property, or you know, from shit from that was there from before, and they didn't bother knocking it out because it just kind of worked out that way. But usually they just clear it all out, you know, throw the grass on, you know, get that up, and then you're ready to go. Sometimes they don't even do that grass shit. So what was I talking about? Oh, yeah, driving at night. Driving at night. Yeah, I like to drive at night, and that led me into the deer. Okay, so, yeah, here we are. We're driving at night. Not a lot of stop signs or intersections or traffic lights here. See, what I was getting at in that little story was, you know, usually, you know, there's couple traffic lights, you know, there's we still got some wilderness, but it's no country like this, you know. It's no Nebraska, no Texas, no Arizona. It's nothing like that. But yeah, man, we got our wildlife. Country driving, nighttime driving. Yeah, you know, and it's kind of like 60 to 70 degrees at night, nice and cool, you know. It's nothing like driving home from a kick-ass you know, hang out with your friends, put the windows down, and you kind of listen to that country, wildlife. You can't hear it right now from outside my window, but you can hear that. Yes, let's all listen to the sounds of the nightlife. Yes. Now all the crickets and the bugs and the Scottish people. Always making noise. Could you sleep with that? I don't know, in the summer, I love having my windows open and listening to all that noise. I can fall asleep listening to that. I don't know, maybe there's people out there that couldn't fall asleep with all that racket. They'd be like, what the fuck, man? Look at all this goddamn noise. City people, that's who. Get a guy from New York, city of New York over here. Yeah, maybe some of you could. Would you tolerate that crap, or would you shut the windows? After shutting the windows, it'd be getting hot, man. I wouldn't advise it. Nightlife. I love nightlife. It's fun. All right, thank you. Thank you very much, nightlife. Woof. All right, desert bus. Yeah, man, desert bus. I remember last time I played just about all of Jim Florentine's terrorizing telemarketer CDs, except for one, which hadn't been released there. So what was that, volume 5, whatever. I haven't played that version yet. I remember it not being as good. I don't know. I'll have to play it. I'll play it sometime down the line for you guys. I'll play it. Should I play the old stuff too? I don't know. I already did that. Should I do it again? See, that's what I'm wondering. Oh, well, whatever. I'll get to it later. Yeah, man, Desert Bus Part 2, man. I hope to make this, make this version or this run through a lot crazier, but you know, it's all you know, kind of a gamble. It's circumstance. If you know, I'm calling the right person, saying the right thing, and getting the right reaction, you know, that's, you know, prank call wise, that's kind of like, you know, you may not get a winner, but we're gonna try. So that's what I'm gonna do right now. I'm sure there's gonna be some shit that's gold, some shit that's filler. Remember last time there was a part where I'm like, all right, everyone, leave me alone, fuck off. I'm just gonna watch this show. What was it, Prison Break? I'm just gonna watch Prison Break, this show from Fox, and I'm not gonna even talk. Fuck you. I don't think that was a very popular video. I think that was my least watched video from the last walkthrough. I'll try to not do too much of that stuff, but hey, this is also about endurance, not just entertainment. And of course, you know, this is part 2. This is just me right now. But man, the time will go by real fast once I get some of those crazy motherfuckers from GameAnyone.com on Skype with me. We're going to be Skyping it up. Skyping it up. And I believe, yeah, man, a year ago, it was the first time I ever talked to such characters as Volvagia, Shadowzak, Scorch, Mace Man. Wow. And a year later, well, I know them a lot better than I used to. And we've worked on a lot of projects. I've become more heavily involved with GameAnyone.com. Very, very more heavily involved. man, I really almost owe it all to Desert Bus. And so do they. They owe a lot of site growth to Desert Bus. I don't think it was technically the first time any GameAnyone.com members have talked, but it was. I think there might have been one or two between Scorch and Mace Man, and they were brief, and it wasn't really anything, you know. So this, you know, fucking Desert Bus a year ago really started a lot of shit, and we pulled in a lot of members and a lot of contributors. You know, we've brought people to the site and we're building it up. I've been part of the staff for a long time now, you know, trying to help the site, you know, create new ideas and ways to make it better. And then, you know, you got people like Mace and Scorch, you know, designing shit for the site. Now there's a whole bunch of us. We all bring something different to the table, and we're always on the lookout for members as well as you know, directors, heavy hitters. I'm gonna continue, you know, 3 years from now. I wonder how things will change, and we can look back on this old Desert Bus walkthrough. You know, I think during part, you know, one of Desert Bus walkthrough and this part two, you know, we've come up with a lot of new crazy ideas, like our live stream now, and we're getting a lot of new features, including our new uploading feature, which is currently in processing right now. We're getting to the final stages of that, and you know, hopefully Mace will be getting that online soon, and who knows where that's going to be. You know, the Desert Bus is kind of responsible for the podcast, the GameAnyone.com podcast, and it's been a lot of fun. You know, the awards that we've had, crazy stuff, the members, and that's just a year. Feels like a lot, really, when you think about it. We've accomplished a lot. So here's to another great year of GameAnyone.com, another great year of GameAnyone.com walkthroughs, and just bringing in more members, and you know, maybe, you know, there's probably going to be you know, new people we haven't heard on this Desert Bus walkthrough. People who haven't been on the first Desert Bus walkthrough. You know, the new faces. So maybe a year from now, people who I haven't even talked to or met will be on a third walkthrough of Desert Bus. Not saying I'm doing a number three trip. I am not saying that at all right now. Oh boy, let's get myself into some trouble. Who knows what'll happen. Oh man, good stuff. Eric Clapton, would you like to help me out here? Play me a tune, Eric Clapton. Yeah, that's it. Play me a tune. There's nothing like good music while you're on the road, especially a long road trip, something like that. You need music, God, especially if you're by yourself. What do you do when you get lonely? Yeah. Nobody's waiting by your side. I like a wide range of music. You know, it's just your foolish pride. Even one country song that I like. Yeah, maybe two. Not big on country, but I'll be playing that one at Desert Bus. Country music and Desert Bus just kind of go together, you know? Desert Bus, country music, I don't know, it's just appropriate, it seems to me. What about Eric Clapton? Eric Clapton, would you like to drive the Desert Bus for a while, please? Alright, he's a little too busy. He's on the bus beside me. I told you, there's a big stage, you know, they're coming along with me. That'd be something. Oh, hey, you know what sucks? It's all black. Have I mentioned that? For you first-time viewers who have not seen part one of this Desert Bus fiasco and just are joining me now and just seeing this black road, you must be just dropping your jaw. You're probably going back to walkthrough number one and be like, okay, come on, what does the rest of this look like? Yeah, can you believe I'm doing this? I'll prove it to you, I'm doing this. I'm gonna go to the right now. I'm gonna go to the left right now. I'm gonna go to the right now. Back to the left. To the right. To the left. To the right. To the right again. Back to the left. You know, it's really annoying. When you wanna go left, it's slower. At least at first. I don't know how to. It's kinda like, I can't do. Okay, there I can do it. It's like, oh, can't go left. Oh, there we go. That's so fast. starts out slow. It's really annoying. God, that's really annoying. But to the right, it's just kind of normal, going to the right mode. And you left, it's slow at first, and it goes real fast. Fuck you, left. Fuck you, left. Left. I'm right-handed. Who here is left-handed? Spotlights, yeah, great headlights. That's so realistic. And I can actually really kind of even picture what it would be like if this game had appropriate, headlights instead of these stupid spotlights. You know, everything kind of just, it would be lit up a little bit, just kind of barely, but only right in front of the bus screen, you know, not further in the distance. That wouldn't be lit up, that would still be dark. Why didn't they do that? Why didn't they just do that? You want to be realistic, right? Right? With the clock, that's realistic.
It's supposed to be realistic.
I didn't do the intro this time. I didn't do the intro to Desert Bus where Penn and Teller talk and discuss about the game. If you want to see that, check out, I think it was part one. There's a lot of that kind of shit. But no, this isn't like that, man. You know, it was just a dream. I woke up. I love this part of the song here because it always reminds me of Goodfellas, by the way. Oh, man. De Niro killed everybody. What are you doing, man? Good stuff. Oh, I hope you find this amusing, folks. You're like, haha, funny? What, am I a clown? Do I amuse you? How am I funny? How am I fucking funny? Well, hold on, Bold. He's a big boy. He can speak for himself. Oh, come on. How the fuck am I funny? Alright? Tell me. Oh, I am funny. You really are a funny guy. Ha ha! I want to watch that movie. I could watch that movie every day, man. Goodfellas. I'm kind of like Jimmy Conway, man. Half Italian, half Irish. Last name, Irish name. Just like, you know, Conway. Interesting stuff. I hope it turns out a little better, though. He ended up in jail. That movie's awesome. For those of you who haven't seen Goodfellas, fucking awesome movie. Go see it. That could have been me, man, back in the 50s. Born in the wrong year. The wrong decade. What could have been? Then I'd probably be dead right now. I'm too crazy. I'm too wild. He's got too much to prove. This segment really carries out for a long time, too. Yes? Yes, is there more? Good stuff. It's hot. Let's mix it up. Let's put my mic right there. Holy fucking shit. That's crazy. If only you guys could see what I'm seeing right now. I just moved my mic. Let's move it back. I can't do this. There we go. Okay. Oh my god, that was nuts. I hope you like that. I hope you will remember the part where I moved my mic for 5 seconds. That'll stand out from years to come. So this is what I do when I normally record. Not my PS3 stuff. I put the mic actually somewhere else. Right now I'm sitting right, you know, in front of my my old monitor, and the microphone is resting on the keyboard. And I always put it on the same spot of the keyboard. Actually, I put it right there. Right next to the question mark button. Alright? Gotta put it right there, and only there. It's gotta be right next to it. It can't be. Now it's here. I can see the period. No, that's too far over. I gotta put it right there. That's what I do every time I record. And then I move the keyboard to a certain spot on my desk so it's lined up. Oh, Jesus! Okay, don't get confused here, Dave. You're gonna crash the fucking bus, man. Are you done yet, song? Whew. Man, I wish I was really driving. It'd be more stimulating. This is not stimulating. I want to be on the road. I just want to be on the road. Again. I want to be on the road again. Right, Willie? Willie.
On the road again.
Yeah, you know.
Just can't wait to get on the road.
Oh, again. You'll eat those words, Willie. I'm gonna kill myself on the road again.
On the road again.
I'm living a hell again. Mace Man should be paying me for this. Cause I can't believe I'm on the fucking road again.
On the road again.
Yeah. Country. Oh. God, that it's not gonna get light for a long time. When did it get dark? Was it 8? Around 7, 8. I think it got dark. Around 8. So I've only been in the dark, counting this new walkthrough, like 4-ish hours. And I got like 5 more to go. So I'm really gonna go, like, this is gonna be even harder, folks. I'm going through the burner, man. I'm going through the burner of hell. This is go time. This is grind time. This is going to be more hardcore. This is going to be more extreme. STDs. You never know, man. It's crazy. I don't know. I can't help it anymore. Something's bad. Something bad's going to happen, man. I'm not going to be held responsible. I got my guns. I got the power of the clogmonger. Really knows. Willie. My name's Willie. Will Nelson. Will Nelson. No, I can't do it. I'm not really a big Willie Nelson fan. But who hates this song? Come on. The road again. Alright, enough. Thanks. See you later. Thank you, Willie. Yeah. Should be applause for me. That should be for me. Whew. Good stuff. Yeah. I'm glad I have that little tree there. We can't have the bus stinking up, can we? We need that nice tree fucking smell or whatever. What do they call it? That oak whatever. Fuck you, tree. Christmas tree. Oh. What if there was like an ice level in Desert Bus? What if it got like, you know, started snowing? God, yeah, I'm just thinking, I mean, the game would still be so annoying and stupid and what the fuck is this crap? But like, let's say, okay, I'm driving. It starts to get, you know, sunny again. It's daytime again. All right. So all of a sudden, you know, it gets cloudy in the sky and then it starts to snow, you know? That'd be cool. Can't you do that? You know, give it something. Why would anyone be playing more than 16 hours of this? Fucking Jesus. And then the roads get snowy. Ooh, yeah, and then things get, like, shaky, you know? Yeah, that'll make it harder. God, just full of brilliant ideas. And I can improve this game so much, starting with the fucking headlights, because that is so just fucking stupid. I can't stand that. Oh, and at first, that bus noise, the... Listen to that. I gotta say, is that annoying anyone? It actually really grows on me. It actually grows on me. I need that sound. If there wasn't that sound, then I would be going insane because there would be no sound. I need sound. I need some sound. Yep. Great sound. Really helps me keep my sanity. You know what else helps me keep my sanity? Those yellow lines. Come on, put yourself in my shoes for a sec here. I'm not wearing shoes. I'm wearing slippers. Slippers? Dave the Usher wears slippers. Anyway, just look at the yellow lines. Just keep focusing. Not nothing but the yellow lines. And it's if you can't even hear my voice anymore. But I'm still talking. The yellow lines. I know. You just slip in and out. The yellow lines keep coming. And that's how I ended up in the girls' locker room naked. Alright, good stuff, man. Oof. Yeah. Oh, we got a lot planned. We got a lot planned. This is just the beginning. As always, this is just an appetizer, all right? So let's transition to our next part. Let's do this. Where's my shortcut key here? Where's my hotkey? Hotkey! Hotkey! Good stuff.